the power of play is not just direct where it's stimulating the mind, but it's also very powerful in a way that it's breaking so many barriers that are created, and kids are allowed to be kids again, just plain simple, enjoy their childhood. I just believe that working with these kids and giving them what they truly need, it's not about deserve, they truly need this attention through play at very young ages. They're like clay, you can mold them. We keep cribbing about why the world is such a bad place and it's filled with such bad elements, and you know, why is somebody a criminal and all of that in this world. But if you trace it back, it always goes back to their childhood. With kindness and love and empathy, I think we can really, really change the way this whole world functions. It became more challenging for us to tell people about the power of play, what is right to play, what's mental well-being at childhood levels. All of these things are very alien concepts to people here. And because there are so many other problems also, still poverty is at a huge level, and I mean, who will talk about play when a child is going hungry? So it becomes even now very challenging for us to articulate this. But having said that, I mean, hunger of the mind is even worse if you ask me, because it can take you to very dark places. It's like climate change, right? You can't really see it, but it's happening all around us. Mental health and mental well-being is very similar. People can't see it. So if you don't see it, you don't think it's a problem. If you start a day in a bad mood, you fought with your husband, mother, father, whatever, whoever at home, you're pretty much in a bad mood the rest of the day. Just imagine that day is your life. Many of these kids have had a bad start to life, and it just goes on for the rest of their lives. I've been a rebel all my life, and I don't believe in conventional things that a lot of people believe in, especially in a country like India, which is full of belief systems. So it wasn't that hard. Luckily for me, they allowed me to be who I am as long as I was financially independent. Threatened came only when we realized that we don't have any money because we were almost broke. Nobody funds organizations like ours. Play is a very Western world concept, is what we've been told to our faces. So it became very challenging for us. We work with almost 55,000 kids every day. And unless and until these kids are mentally nourished, are able to understand what's right from wrong by themselves, nothing is going to really change.